Okay, so apparently they have taken down the address to Revived Archive. Thank you, YouTube, for finally listening. Unfortunately, that means that Adonis Paul now wants me dead. Literally, he is telling his people to kill me. He is using different language, so I will have to spell it out. But here we go. The address to Revived Archive has been removed due to Adrastia's reporting. Hallelujah! Thank the Lord. I think you should do whatever you think is right, as much as you think is necessary. Remember, she's not a victim and should never be treated as such. At this point, if she is still on YouTube, I blame you, not her. Apparently, when she cries and whines, you buy it. Her behavior goes unreported. If she can get something done, you should be able to as well. Well, it looks like I will be releasing a video today compiled from 40 of her deleted videos from November 1st. Pause. Whenever that's uploaded, I will be reporting it. Unpause. I will do this every month until she is gone. In addition, other male featurettes will follow, detailing how she blackmailed her dying mother. Not what happened. And how she admitted to assisting her 24-year-old transgender husband rape a 16-year-old. Not what happened. How she goes after people's jobs. Not what happened. Sponsors. Not what happened. And channels. I went after the channels that have been pushing me to kill myself and taking my content for their own. Like you. A man she admitted. No. That was something that was a delusion that they pushed into my head. My goal now is to show you her words and only her words and make you as hated as possible. And you woke up and chose to battle. Now it's on. I have watched you cry and whine over literally nothing. I wonder how you will respond when every bad thing I've ever done and admitted online is dragged out again in your own words. There will be no pity for you. There will be no mercy. And I am not responsible for what people do. Note that there's no pity, no mercy. He's not responsible for what people do, and he desperately wants me gone. This, in addition to Owl's transcripts, which I truly believe will show Mary to be a monster who has been lying about her level of involvement in the murder of a disabled woman. It's okay, the Tardnomicon has all her videos and is on multiple platforms. I did strike the Tardnomicon this morning, and I don't know how long it will take YouTube to look at that, but so you're aware, I am actually telling YouTube things now. I will make a video quickly to explain what's changed, but let me finish this. I didn't do it, then James made this happen to you, but today I will be showing a number of videos where you scream and are going to report everyone. Then just disappear, hoping people think it. Don't think it's you. After posting your baiting video this morning, good luck convincing people it was him. Might have been, who knows, but the evidence from your own mouth says you. In addition to all this, I will be uploading the SEO on my site along with the redesign to ensure nothing Mary has ever done, including 100% of her embarrassing videos, can ever be wiped offline and will always be easily searchable. Good job. You woke up feeling pretty happy today. You did this to you. Was it worth it? Just gonna keep this documented because I will have the money for a lawsuit one day. I promise you, I will have the money for a lawsuit one day. Anyways, let me turn my face on real quick and do some quick explaining. Because yes, things have changed a little bit. I have begun reporting the channels that are treating me this way. I reported the archive because those are my videos. I don't want my videos uploaded to somebody else's channel. And YouTube has given me the option to have that taken down. It was literally nothing but my videos. I have the right on YouTube to say who uploads my videos. That includes your channel. I went a long time without reporting because you threatened me. You might not remember, it was very early on. You threatened me that every time you got a report, every time somebody, anybody got a report, anybody reported for me, if you heard about it, I would suffer. And it's been 3 years, and it's gotten to the point where you cannot do more than you already have. You push and push and push because you want me to kill myself. You take things that were literally delusions and forced into me, and you mock me and you use them as truth when you know that I'm delusional at the time. He goes after mentally ill people. And then he uses their mental illness against them to make them hurt themselves. And YouTube platforms it and monetizes it. And it's wrong. And my goal is to stop it. If that means he's off YouTube, he's off YouTube. You should not be monetized to mentally abuse mentally ill people. You should not profit off of harassing a mentally ill person to the point that they want to hurt themselves. That should not be something that makes you money. But it is. And I am finally standing up for myself, because 2024 is not going to be a repeat of 2023 and 2022 and fucking 2021 and 2020. I'm not doing it anymore. I'm not doing it anymore. If you hurt me, from now on, I will report it and tell somebody. Because you have been doing this for 3 years and threatening me if I reported you, it would only get worse. I guess it's going to get worse, which means that it will enter legal territory. And I'm ready for that, because fuck you, man. 2024 will be different. I will be working and saving for the lawsuit to come against you for shit like this. This exact kind of intimidating, threatening harassment, all because I did something that is my right to do. If I don't like the way you're using my content, YouTube has given me the option to tell them that. If your reaction is bullying and threatening and throwing your thousands of followers at me to hurt me, you should not be on YouTube. Period. What you're doing is wrong. And one day people will know it.